name is Dean Lin. I am one of the advisors at Minnesota New Country School. I have been here for 10 years, 11 years. I was hired the second year, and my son and daughter went to the school the first year. We're located in Henderson, Minnesota. The difference between our school probably and a traditional school is that traditional school is really stresses developing knowledge or instilling knowledge in students, whereas we really stress the application, and we believe that when you really push the application, the knowledge has to come out of that. What a traditional school and a traditional teacher does is you maybe say the mechanics of teaching, lesson plans, classes, time management, all those things. What we're trying to do is to help the students develop those abilities to do the planning, to do the time management. I had a student a number of years ago that kept on asking me, give me a worksheet, just let me do that. I said, I won't, but I would certainly look forward to you making your own worksheet. Because it seems to me that many times teachers do all the things that are the most critical and most important as far as planning the classes and doing all those things for the students. And even in traditional schools, you could spend that time with the students and doing those things. I mean, you could work with them in developing worksheets. Okay, what parts of this information this information is the most critical.
And these are skills they can use later in life.
Those are skills
they're going to have to have many of them.
They have to have them anyway. And where are they going to get them?
Unless they're going to be followers all their life.
Right. Otherwise, they're going to be somebody flipping burgers at McDonald's or whatever. And our factory workers. And that's not what we want our children to be. That's certainly not how we're going to be better as a society and as better as a country. So I think the skills that they can develop in a atmosphere like this, in an educational atmosphere like this, is extremely valuable.
Great. Okay, that ought to do it. Hey, thanks a lot. You're going to be in a Hollywood movie here. How long have you been here?
2 years.
Tell me about academics, because that's what school is supposed to be about. In your regular school, how did you do in academics as compared to what you're doing here?
I've always been an A student. Okay. It's just that there was not a lot of one-on-one action, so I struggled a lot, you know. I struggled really, really hard because I was never able to have a teacher, you know, to just sit with me and tell me, okay, this is what you do, this is how you do it. I always had to learn on my own a lot of the times, mm-hmm. and considering that my parents forgot a lot about their high school years, they really couldn't help me, you know, as much. So coming here, you know, I was able to really sit down and have one-on-one action with all the staff.
So anytime you have a question to someone there?
Anytime, and if Paul is not, you know, available, then Mandy is, and if she's not, Joe is, and if, you know, if there's just, you just can't see all of the staff being busy, like all of the staff not being able to sit with a student. You know, it's really important for us to learn, and it's really important for us to stay on task because it's very comfortable here.
Thank you.
Another turning point, a fork stuck in. Well, he's in the orientation for GSA.
You're an advisor here?
Yes, I am.
Just a couple of questions. Have you taught in regular systems before?
I have, yes. I've taught in private school, in large public school.
Give me a little short synopsis about the difference that you see in a regular, what I call a faculty.
Here, which is a good thing and also a difficult thing, is that you learn about all the roles that are played in high school, a regular large high school, like the guidance counselor, mm-hmm. and the attendance clerk, and the...
You have to be the cook and bottle washer.
Exactly.
Everything, right.
Like learning, recently I'm just learning and struggling with things about credit and transferring of grad standards from one system to another system.
So it's a big learning curve for you also.
Exactly. Yeah. So you don't have to do that in a large high school.
No.
It's like it's all the admin.
Mm-hmm. Let them take care of it.
The office does that. Yeah. And the kids here have to know that. So the kids are like managing their own affairs totally. It's like giving them their bank account and their paycheck and their the rent they have to pay. They're doing it all, you know, and so are we. About running the school, and so it's very intense because you feel like you feel responsible for what happens.
Can you see yourself going back to a normal environment?
I don't think so, unless it really changed a lot. No, right.
Unless it changed like this.
Yes, that's right. It would have to be like little small learning communities where we cheer.
Did you find it difficult to acclimate into this system?
I personally didn't, because I'm kind of a social person. You know, I mean, I thrive on relationships and close contact with my neighbors. And anything I've ever done, I've gotten close with the people, because that's important to me.
And here you get to know not only the students, but your family life. And
Parents, you know, and there's so many active parents. And
because a lot of kids bring a lot of baggage to school.
Yeah, they do. They do. And because you get so close with them, and you have an opportunity to talk with them a lot, you hear it. They build trust with them.
Thank you.
Yeah, good luck.
I need it.